a small example that some are pointing out that shows Pakistani leadership's disregard for rules. The United Nations gives you 15 odd minutes to finish your speech. The Pakistani leader took 50.
Yeah, his light was blipping.
Yes. So he took forever to make a point, and out of these 50 minutes, at a time when he himself said that his country has lots of challenges which the world could have contributed to resolving, he spent 25 minutes talking about Kashmir. What does that say about
Kashmir?
And how should the Pakistanis see this?
It is. I'm disappointed because of the fact you said Pakistan's official policies violate every agreement. They are not in the business of accepting and agreeing to any agreement. Whether it's Shimla agreement or any Tashkent agreement, they have never agreed. Even the United Nations, he had the gall to tell United Nations to interfere in India's internal matters when United Nations ought to be actually asking Pakistan to vacate the area occupied by it as a step number one. That was option number one, the three conditions that were laid down. We all know, in simple arithmetic, we know one precedes two, two precedes three, three, four comes after three. You can't do the fourth before doing the one. But the issue here is very important, that it is a pity. And I say, people of India must take note of this. You know now where this Prime Minister, what this man is thinking, what is the thinking of this country towards India. It's pure evil. It's not settlement of Kashmir. It's because to maintain their status quo with India. India has offered so many times, Aman Ki Asha, four times war, we surrendered, gave them back their 96,000 soldiers. But there is no goodwill you see from Pakistan, not at all. So Honorable Professor, who is a very, definitely an honorable man and a learned man, he indulged in a little bit of a talking about as if we, India, had two big PR battle. It's not a PR battle. If you are suffering from cancer and if you are not attending to that, you can't indulge in PR battle of looking good. You are not looking good because you are suffering from cancer. And that's the state of affairs in Pakistan, that Prime Minister of Pakistan threatens India. And I think it's time for every Indian to become aware and acknowledge this fact that Aman Ki Asha was a good attempt, it failed. Hmm. With Pakistan, if they want a nuclear, you have to call their nuclear bluff. Sadly so, there are times when it comes, you draw a Lakshman Rekha and you say this far and no further. And that time has
come. I think
come.
That's something that they've been doing they have, with the surgical strikes.
Yeah,
with the
they have done it now. Now it is being taken in an even more forceful manner. And Prime Minister ignored Pakistan in the UN because of the simple fact that you don't matter to us anymore. Keep shouting, keep beating the drum, but you don't matter to us anymore.
And that's the reason why President Trump was very supportive of Prime Minister Modi. And that's the reason, and if you hear President Trump's UN address, he called out China, who is basically taking on the issues of Uyghurs and Muslims who are there. And here he's trying to be a big beating the drum of the greatest messenger of Islam. And at the same time, not even recognizing the abuse being done by China, because who are their godfathers?
But President Trump didn't call out Pakistan. You and I don't agree on President Trump and where he stands. Well, so he says, I'm India's friend and I'm Pakistan's friend and I'm going to intervene if both sides want. And then one side says, we do not want intervention. And he says it again. So
What it is we do need Pakistan help. And also you have to realize, we have had a 70-year relationship with Pakistan. And the relationship with India is 20 years and still growing and maturing. And it has come from Prime Minister Manmohan Singh along with Prime Minister Modi to new high ground. Mm. And that's what it is. It takes time to build. We Americans build deeper relationships. And most importantly, religious freedom has become one of our greatest point of national security. And it's one of our pillars. And I think when President Trump saw with Prime Minister Modi a great partner in promoting religious freedom, and that's the reason when Prime Minister Modi said peace and harmony, I think that's what they were promoting. And whereas Pakistan is keep harping about Kashmir and they're not going and talking about Karachi and Kabul where they're promoting terrorism.
Right. Dr. Barai, ever since Article 370 was revoked, Pakistan has been at it. You know, they tried to gather support. They went to the Chinese. They dispatched the foreign minister, who said in a press conference, I'm going to dash to Beijing, although Beijing gave him time for 2 days later, and so he had to wait. They went to the European Union. They went to the OIC, Organization of Islamic Countries. They've tried friends and allies and pretty much everyone, including the United Nations. And in the last 2 months, they haven't got much traction. Even countries like the UAE have told Pakistan that this is your own business. Settle it yourselves. Are you worried then they will try something more provocative because this reaching out has not succeeded?
You know, this reminds me of Osama bin Laden. Osama bin Laden took it upon himself that wherever he feels that, quote unquote, there is an injustice to the Muslim, he has to go and write to attack there and do the terrorism. So sitting in Afghanistan, he sent the people in the United States and killed more than 3,000 people. Imran Khan is taking the same role. What business he has to mess around in Kashmir? I mean, just he himself thinks that the 6 million Kashmiris or Muslims are being treated like this. Who gave him that authority? What kind of mandate, from where did he get that he has to mess around where he perceives something is happening for the Muslims? I mean, Kashmir was never part of Pakistan. Pakistan became separated from India, and Kashmir was never part of it. So this whole philosophy that they've developed, like Osama bin Laden, that somehow that they have the mandate, self-given mandate, to try to mess around and then do the terrorism. Same thing they do. Oh, there is injustice to Muslims in America, so the guys have to put up the bomb in Times Square. Same thing in France, same thing in United Kingdom, same thing in Spain. Now, what will he do? After the United Nations Assembly is over, things will cool down because there is not an international forum for him to make the noise. Could he try for some mischief, either a terrorist attack or a small kind of not state-sponsored or officially not state-sponsored kind of little mischief? It's possible that he might do that, again, to try to draw the world's attention. Because once the UN General Assembly adjourns tonight, well, there is not an international forum for him to mess around.
Well, that's the reason we had the
trucks. Yes, Professor Rajgopal, do you think this is a wasted opportunity for Pakistan in the sense that at a time when they are in such dire straits when it comes to their economy, they could have used this platform for a lot of gain, like tangible gain, and yet they turned it into one week-long propaganda exercise, and they'll have very little show for it back home.
That's possible. And it just seems to me, you know, yes, we can say Article 370 is a digression that's behind us, but look at what is happening. There is a calculation here. We have a story on our hands. We're trying to apply hard power. Perhaps the lesson is soft power. Now, India is on a very good wicket. The world, compared to Pakistan, India is a successful state. Everybody is prepared to say, whatever problem you have with Kashmir, we are happy to treat it as an internal problem. The question is, how long will that remain the case? How long? And Imran Khan is gambling that perhaps together with external provocation, there is an abundant fodder, you know, it is waiting to catch fire. You cannot subjugate a majority population in the way that they are attempting to do.
Where is subjugating the population? So we're mixing up things. Too many broad strokes here.
India has a population of 1,300 million.
We're talking about Kashmir.
Talking
about Kashmir.
So are you telling me that in
Kashmir signed, the Maharaja signed an instrument of accession according to which there were certain provisions which have been constitutionally through irregularity.
My friend.
That is what Imran Khan is bringing to the United Nations. And we are asking, why is he doing that?
We're trying to say.